Good morning all. Welcome to this session on oscillators. Okay, so in the previous class we have discussed the LC oscillators. Okay, there are Hartley and Colpitts oscillator, and the detailed analysis of Colpitts oscillator we have taken up, and we have derived the frequency of oscillation and the feedback factor. Okay, so it's continuation part. So we'll be discussing the crystal oscillators. The same configuration as Colpitts we'll use, but the thing is we will use a material called as crystal, piezoelectric crystal we will use in the feedback path. Okay, so we'll first analyze what is crystal and its characteristics, and then we'll see the crystal oscillator circuit and then problem on that. Okay, a piezoelectric crystal such as quartz, okay, maybe in your watches and all they will be using this, okay, for synchronization. Okay, quartz exhibit electromechanical resonance characteristics. Okay, so it will exhibit a resonance characteristics. We have studied resonance last time. Okay, so electromechanical resonance characteristics it will exhibit, and they are very stable. Okay, so Colpitts oscillator drawback we have given, it is unstable. Frequency stability is a major issue, right? But whereas if you use a crystal, the crystal itself is a very stable. So with time and temperature, okay, time as well as in changes in the temperature, it is very much stable, and it is highly selective. So selective factor is also we are mentioning, meaning having very high Q factors. Okay, Q factor also we have gone in the resonance part, right? For inductor and capacitor we have the Q factors. Okay, and it is highly selective one. Okay, that is the property of this crystal. The circuit symbol of a crystal. Okay, so circuit symbol, how we use it in our circuits, so that I have shown in figure A. Okay, and its equivalent circuit, what it consists of. Okay, equivalent circuit is written here. Okay, previously also we have learned many such symbols, right? BJT means what symbol, its equivalent circuit. Okay, FET, its equivalent circuit. MOSFET, its equivalent circuit. Okay, any active device if we consider to do the analysis, okay, we require the equivalent circuit. Same way now we are learning this crystal. Okay, so it is having a, this is a symbol for crystal. So both side like a capacitor you have the walls, and in between we have a rectangular shape. Okay, very thick rectangular shape we will denote it. So it denotes the crystal. Sometimes we will write along with it is a crystal like that. Okay, so this is the symbol we'll be using, and what it behaves, electromechanical resonance characteristic exhibits. No, for that what it consists of, that is your figure B. Okay, so it is having an inductor L in series with a capacitor denoted as CS. Okay, in series with that, and there is a small resistance R. Okay, and this is in parallel with another capacitor denoted as P. In the case of Colpitts oscillator, the same capacitors we have taken like C1, C2. Okay, the same thing here in the crystal oscillator I have taken CS and CP denoted. So equation wise it will come same as Colpitts oscillator. Okay, so you can compare that later. Okay, you have the inductor, additional one is resistor, but resistance is very small, it will not play major role in frequency finding out. Okay, but it will be having a Q factor, in that we will be using this. Okay, so let us go further. Okay, so this is about the crystal, its symbol and equivalent circuit. Okay, we'll explain about that. The resonance properties are characterized by a large inductance. The inductance which I shown you, it is a very large there, L, as high as hundreds of henries. Okay, and a very small series capacitance CS, as small as 0.005 picofarad. Okay, such a small we will be using in that, and along with a series resistance R. Okay, representing a Q factor omega naught L by R. So it is involved in the Q factor determination. Based on that, we are selecting that. That can be as high as few hundred thousand. Okay, which is Q factor. Okay, we'll be having problem. We'll see in terms of thousands, we'll getting the answer. Okay, and along with a parallel capacitance CP, a few picofarads. Okay, so capacitor CP represents the electrostatic capacitance between the two parallel plates of the crystal. Okay, and note that here the CP which I have taken will be much larger than the CS, because CS is very small we have told, and CP has few picofarads, so it should be much larger than the CS. Okay, so that is what the equivalent circuit explanation. Okay, So now we'll represent this as an impedance, because all you have is the passive elements, right? Resistor, capacitor, inductor. Okay. So if you apply there, okay, the what impedance means what? V by I, right? So if you find out the, if you apply the KVL there, okay, or just the impedance V of S by I of S, instead of writing V of S, I of S, and then taking the ratio, directly we can say as equivalent impedance. Okay. Since the Q factor is very high, okay, we may neglect the resistance R and express the crystal impedance as. We'll consider only three elements now, which is that capacitor CP, capacitor CS, and inductor L. Resistor we will not consider for simplicity purpose, okay, because it does not affect in that. So Z of S is equal to 1 divided by, so what you have there, okay. So in the parallel, you have the SCP, right? 1 divided by, so it is all parallel, no? So you have to consider like this. So numerator 1 divided by 1 divided by, parallel plate we have done, no? So this 1 divided by 1 by CSP is nothing but SCP will come, okay? So it will come in the numerator directly, plus 1 divided by, so this separately we are considering, because these two are in series now. So this combination is in parallel with this combination, that's why plus. And then when it comes to left side branch, where you have inductor and capacitor, they are in series, that's why 1 divided by SL plus 1 by SCS. Okay, so it is capacitance, no? That's why. So now we have to go for the we have to represent this in a some manipulated form, so that we can find it its frequency. Okay, so like that we'll do some modification here, try to understand. Okay, so there are a few steps are there. So first thing first, I will start from this. Okay, I will take the LCM over here. 1 by SCS is there, no? So first this part I will take the LCM and write it below this 1. Okay, so 1 divided by SCP plus 1 divided by, so this SCS will multiply with numerator, S square LCS will come, plus 1 whole divided by SCS. Okay, so then this SCS, you can take it in the here numerator. Okay, it will be multiplied with 1 and we can write. So like that we'll continue. In the next step, I will show that. So 1 divided by SCP, no changes. So this SCS, which was the denominator, I brought it over here. Okay, so this is the next step. So in the next step, I will take the LCM of this here. Okay, SCP with S square LCS plus 1. I'm multiplying all the terms here. SCP into S square LCS. What you will get? S square S, S cube you will get. Then L is there, CS and CP is there. Okay, so that's why LCP CS plus 1 is there, so 1 into SCP, that's why SCP. Then you have here SCS whole divided by this denominator, S L square LCS plus 1. So now this you can take it in the numerator in the next step. Okay, so that only I have done here. S square LCS will multiply with 1 plus 1 divided by this denominator, S cube LCP CS SCP plus SCS. Okay, so I hope it is clear till here. Okay, first we have written the impedance, then started with the taking the LCMs, right? So now we have come to this stage. So now we have to simplify this, because it is in Laplace transform, right? So we'll divide the both numerator and denominator by LCS, because this term I will try to remove from S square. Okay, so make it as S square only. Okay, so I will try to remove that. So what will happen will be explained next. Okay, we try to bring it in some form. Okay, so what you get? So here LCS divided, directly I have written S square plus 1 was there right side, so that's why 1 divided by LCS will come. Okay, similarly denominator term, each individually I will divide it there. So first term was S square LCP CS divided by LCS, here SCP by LCS plus here SCS by LCS. Okay, so here first here LCS will cancel out, so what is remaining is numerator as it is, S square plus 1 by LCS, and denominator it will become S cube into CP, only two terms remaining. Okay, and then here also you can cancel out CS, but I am not doing that. If I cancel again, it will come back and again multiply with that. Instead, WhatsApp I had taken here is these two I have combined here. Okay, so both LCM is same and S is common in this, so S I have taken outside. And I have written CP plus CS. Okay, even that step you can do it here also. Okay, Cp plus Cs divided by LCs. Okay, so this is the step I have done next. And then what I will try to do is I will separate out SCP. So I will take one SCP from this. Okay, because here S square is there. So denominator also I will try to bring S square term. So to bring that S square term, what I have to do? One S and one CP I have to separate out. So that's what I have written over here. 1 by SCP I have separated out into S square plus 1 by LCS as it is there. Okay. And then here you got S square. Okay. So then to bring this form here. Okay. So to satisfy this SCP taken outside now. So S is already outside. So that's why this SC is taken there. But CP is not there in this equation. That's why that CP I have included in the denominator. So when you multiply this term with this, so that CP will cancel out and S will come over here. Okay. Hope you are understanding this. Okay. Simplification. So this is CP plus CS by LCS CP. Okay. So this is try to bring it in a form S square plus form. Okay. So make it as equation one. So this will bring it some form now. Okay. So this is nothing but I will try to denote this as a omega S. Okay. Series frequency. And this I try to call it as a parallel frequency. Okay. So that I will tell you next. Okay. So remember this. So from figure B, we see that the crystal has two resonance frequencies. Okay. So from that equation one, it is observation. So what are that? One is series resonance at omega S. Okay. Series resonance at omega S, that is frequency. One frequency, that frequency is 1 by square root of LCS. Numerator I have taken S square plus 1 by root LCS. No. So that will be root LCS I have taken. Okay. There it is. LCS is there. So this is one frequency and a parallel resonance at another frequency omega P, denoted as omega P, which is given as 1 divided by square root of L CSCP by CS plus CP. This is same as your Colpitts oscillator. Yes. Okay. So in Colpitts oscillator, you had L here C1 C2 by C1 plus C2 you had. The same we call it as omega P in this case. Okay. Along with omega S is there. Now if we do this substitution in equation 1, along with substitution of S equal to J omega. So what you will get? Okay. So you'll take the first equation again. So 1 by SP was there. So it becomes J omega into CP. Then multiplication you had S square place J omega square have included plus 1 by LCS is there. And even you can write this as 1 by square root of LCS whole square. Okay. Because we have to bring it in omega S square form. Okay. So then J omega square here, S square was there, J omega square, then remaining no changes. Okay. CP plus CS by LCS CP. This as it is, just wherever S is there, I have substituted plus J omega. Next, we'll do the simplification. So 1 by J, we can write it as minus J. So that's what I have done for first term. So minus J by omega CP. Then here, J omega square means J square omega square. So omega square, J square is minus 1. So minus omega square plus. So this I will substitute now equation 2 now. What is equation 2? 1 by root LCS is omega S. What is 1 by LCS? So taking square on both sides. So it is omega S square. Okay. So first time now, a little bit difficult to analyze. So slowly you understand that. And once you write the notes, you will understand. Okay. Then similarly here, J square omega square will come. So again, it will give you J square is minus 1 and omega square. Plus this is we have taken as L CSCP divided by CS plus CP. It is in the denominator, right? 1 divided by it is there. So if you write this in the 1 divided form, so you'll get the same thing, right? 1 divided by L CSCP by CS plus CP. That only you'll get. And this is in square form, okay? Square root form. So if you bring it in outside, remove the square, it will come square here. Okay, that's why it is written omega P square. So now I want to remove this minus sign from here. Okay, so let it be outside minus as it is. So minus J 1 by omega CP, let it be as it is. Here I will minus sign, I will take common. So if I take minus sign common here, what will happen? So this will come here minus, right? Similarly, here also I will take minus sign common. Here minus sign will come and these two minus will cancel out. So the same expression I can write it as omega square minus omega S square by omega square minus omega P square. So this is one of the important relation of the piezoelectric crystal. Okay. Its impedance. Okay. Very much essential. Okay. So what is its inherent property impedance that will be indicated by this equation 4. So this was what we have done from equation 1. Whatever we have taken, we simplified taking LCM, and finally we brought it in a form where we have included the both series resonance and parallel resonance frequencies. Okay, hope it is clear till here. Okay, let us move further. So from equations 2 and 3, we note that omega p is much larger than omega s. Okay, so the series parallel resonance frequency is much larger than series resonance frequency. However, parallel capacitor Cp is much larger than Cs. Okay, so which is Cp is, this earlier also we have told, the two resonance frequencies are very close. Okay, so expressing Z of j omega as j into x of omega. Okay, so the crystal reactance x omega will have the sharp shape as shown in figure, have the shape as shown in figure C. Okay, so the real part is made zero here. Z of j omega means, so just imaginary part, j into x of omega is indicated, and x of omega means reactance and resistance. The resistance part we have removed, right? So it is a small, we have removed, that's why not considered. That's why j into x of omega. So that reactance curve, we have tried to draw it over here. Okay, so this is the curve. Okay, so at omega s. Okay, so how it will behave? The bottom part is a capacitive effect. Okay, so this is due to Cs. Okay, so this is due to maybe Cs, and the inductive at the top, which will be due to the L. Okay, very high L, it's Krakaty, and this is due to maybe your parallel plate capacitance Cp. Okay, so this is the shape it will take when you draw the crystal reactance versus frequency curve. Okay, so this is some of the characteristics of the piezoelectric crystal. Okay, and some of the equations. Okay, now let us see the circuit, different configurations we can form the crystal oscillators. Okay, we observe that the crystal reactance is inductive. Crystal reactance is inductive over the very narrow frequency band. So the frequency band is very close there, right? Omega s and omega p. Okay, for a given crystal, this frequency band is well defined. Thus, we may use the crystal to replace the inductor of the Colpitts oscillator. Okay, so this is the first configuration we are seeing in the Colpitts oscillator. Same Colpitts oscillator circuit. So you had two capacitors in series, and that is in parallel with inductor, right? So that inductor we will remove, and we'll place the crystal symbol now. So it will form a variant of Colpitts oscillator we have seen, right? Clap oscillator. Same way, this is another variant including the crystal. That's why it is called as crystal oscillator. Okay, so that is one of the circuit. The resulting circuit will oscillate at the resonance frequency of the crystal inductance L with the series equivalent of Cs and Cp. Okay, so Cs and Cp plus C1 C2 divided by C1 plus C2. Okay, so that is its equivalent. Okay, value. Since Cs is much smaller than the three other capacitances, it will be dominant. So Cs will be the dominant one. That's why this part is removed. Only Cs will be considered. Okay, so this Cp plus C1 C2 by C1 plus C2 is a very small compared to Cs. It is neglected. Because of that, you will get the frequency of oscillation for this type of oscillator circuit. In very short, we have explained this. Even the circuit I have not drawn at all. Okay, so that is given by square root of LCS. Okay, so you know already. So whatever we have told series resonance frequency in the previous one, it is same as the frequency here. In the case of variant of Colpitts oscillator circuit, where we have removed inductor and placed the piezoelectric crystal. Okay, so this is the circuit, another circuit. Okay, for another configuration we will be using the crystal, and this is the step we will be using in laboratory also. Okay, so here we have used a CMOS inverter amplifier. Okay, so here it is shown QP and here it is shown QN, meaning it is a N channel MOSFET and this is a P channel MOSFET. Okay, and this is a CMOS inverter shape. And for that, we have connected a feedback resistor RF, and this is a R1, and in the R1, so this is the output phase. Okay, this output is connected to the crystal here. Okay, piezoelectric crystal is connected over here, and the capacitors are there as usual. Okay, so variant of Colpitts oscillator told you. So the two capacitors are there. Previously we have drawn one equivalent circuit for Colpitts oscillator. So here instead of BJT I am using a CMOS inverter. Okay, digital CMOS inverter, and this is feedback network. You have two capacitance. Okay, in series. Okay, in between you have an inductor. Right. So this inductor is given as feedback to the input. Because of that, it is called as a crystal oscillator circuit. Okay, so we are not explaining much. You should know the circuit. Okay, how to draw it. So laboratory, there may be little changes or to get the output. Okay, so almost similar variant means you will have an amplifier circuit, and in the feedback we'll have a crystal. Okay, and it will produce the oscillation. So in addition to the basic Colpitts oscillator, a variety of configuration exist for crystal oscillators. There are various variety are there. Okay, so next we'll be seeing another also Miller oscillator like that. Okay, so here figure D already I have shown you. It is a popular configuration of the crystal oscillator called the Pierce oscillator. Okay, it is called as the Pierce oscillator name, utilizing a CMOS inverter as amplifier. Okay, the resistor RF is there, which determines the DC operating point. Okay, what is DC operating point? So making the device on, right? So CMOS inverter first should be on, right? So making it on Q point in the high gain region of the CMOS inverter, where you have the high gain. So in that region it will generate the, determine the operating point. And along with, we have resistor R1 there, which is together with capacitor C1, okay, provides a low pass filter that discourages the circuit from oscillating at a higher harmonic of the crystal frequency. I told you crystal oscillator is a very stable, right? That stability it has to exhibit, right? How it will do. So for that, this resistor R1 and C1 provide a low pass filter. Filter means what? It will filter out, okay, or discourages the circuit from oscillating at a higher harmonic of the crystal frequency. Okay, it will limit the noises. Okay, note that the circuit is also based on the Colpitts configuration. So everything is based on Colpitts. Okay, that's why Colpitts is famous. That only we have discussed. Okay, so first circuit also Colpitts. We have not shown the circuit. Okay, same as that, just crystal is placed parallelly. Now this is another configuration called as Pierce oscillator configuration, whereas its amplifier is CMOS inverter now. Okay, and it is also a variant of Colpitts configuration. The extremely stable resonance characteristics and the very high Q factors of the quartz crystal result in oscillators with very accurate and stable frequencies. This is the advantage of using crystal as a feedback frequency selective network. Okay, so it will produce very accurate and stable frequencies as results. Crystals are available with resonance frequencies in the range of few kilohertz to hundreds of megahertz. Okay, normally it will be in megahertz range. That is the frequency of a piezoelectric crystal, and temperature coefficients of omega naught of 1 or 2 parts per million per degree Celsius are achievable. Okay, so omega naught is an oscillating frequency. The temperature coefficients of the frequency of 1 or 2 parts per million per degree Celsius are achievable. Unfortunately, however, crystal oscillators being mechanical resonators are fixed frequency circuits. Okay, we could not vary the frequency of that as we have in RC or LC oscillators. Okay, because its frequency is fixed, that's why it is normally used as mechanical resonators. Okay, so this is about the discussion on the crystal oscillator. Okay, so just whatever equation I have seen, just we try to solve a problem here, a very simple straight away problem. So question is, a 2 megahertz crystal, okay, frequency is given, 2 megahertz crystal, quartz crystal is specified to have L is equal to 0.52 Henry, CS, series capacitance, equal to 0.012 picofarad, parallel CP is equal to 4 picofarad, CL, CP is much larger than CS. Okay, this should be satisfied when they are giving problem, right? Okay, 4 picofarad, and R is small in terms of 100, right? 120 ohm. So you have to find the series resonant frequency FS, parallel resonant frequency FB, and the quality factor Q factor Q. Okay, so these three you have to measure. So straight away you have to use the formula. So what is omega S? 1 by root LCS, right? So from that FS is nothing but
1 by 2 pi root LCS. Okay, equation 2 and 3 we have seen. Okay, in the equivalent circuit derivation there. Okay, so just substitute L is 0.52 and LCS is 0.012 pico, 10 to the power minus 12. So use the calculator and don't keep it as 2. Okay, because 2 megahertz is the oscillating frequency of the crystal. So now we are finding the another frequency, that is FS. Okay, series resonant frequency, which will be having some difference. Okay, in resonance part we have learned. Okay, so that's why you have to take till some 3 or 4 decimal points. Okay, so I will get some 2.014 something, we'll get, make it as 5, 2.015 megahertz. So if you have the calculator, you can verify this answer. Okay, so I will send the notes after this. You can write down and you can check. Okay, so next what you have to find, Fe and Q. Okay, so left side I have the Fe calculation. Just look at, so what is the formula for Fe? Omega P we know, 1 divided by square root of L into CS CP by CS plus CP. Now they have asked frequency in hertz, Fp, right? So that's why you have to take 1 by 2 phi. Omega P by 2 phi you have to substitute. So that's why 2 phi will come outside. So root L into CS by CP by CS plus CP. So substitute all the values. So 0.52, CS is 0.012 picofarad, CP is 4 picofarad. Okay, so here multiplication and in the denominator addition. Okay, so start doing the calculation. First to take this part, multiplication and addition, take the ratio, multiply with 0.52, you'll get some answer. Take the square root of answer and that answer you multiply with 2 phi and keep that answer, then 1 divided by answer you make, you'll get 0.017 something you will get. So I have made 0.018 megahertz. Okay, so how much point you have approximated FS? Same point. Okay, 3 point or 4 point approximation you have done. No, same thing you do. Okay, so there is a clear cut difference, that is 0.015, this is 2.018, and that difference may be sometimes called bandwidth, right? So that is not asked here, but I'm telling you one. Okay, next part is Q factor. Okay, so Q factor formula they have given very early, right? Omega naught L into L divided by R. So omega naught means oscillating frequency of the crystal, which is given 2 megahertz crystal, right? So that's why you should not take this FS or FE, okay, value. Instead, you have to take 2 megahertz crystal, they have told. So you have to take 2 into 10 to the power 6. And again here, omega naught they have specified. It is radian per second, right? And this frequency given is in hertz. So you have to convert that. You have to multiply 2 phi. Okay, if you does not do, you will not get the answer properly. So you have to multiply with 2 phi. Into 0.52 L value divided by resistance R is 120 ohm. So do the calculation and you will get the answer as 54,455. I told you while discussing, right? Q factor will come in terms of thousands. I don't know how many thousands, right? That's why it is highly selective. So in textbook, they have given answer 55,000. You can take 54,455. You have taken, approximated it to 55,000. Okay. So this is the answer for this problem. FS, FE and Q factor calculation. You should know, remember these three formula. You can solve this. Okay. So the last problem of this session, okay, or the module 2. Okay. So there is a small discussion I have, so that I will continue. It is the variant of, or some note on, okay, Colpitts oscillator. So variant of some circuits. So it is called as Miller oscillator. Okay. So as like we have studied Clapp oscillator, a variant of Colpitts, same way we are discussing this. Okay. So just listen. Miller oscillators are generally used in electromechanical applications. Okay. So we'll be discussing electrical applications. There are electromechanical systems also there, right? So that applications, Miller type of oscillator will be using. The basic structure of Miller oscillator is shown in figure. Okay, so it will be having a transistor with a, it will be indicated by some Q factor, then coupling capacitor CC and inductor LC. Okay, inductor and capacitor it will be having at the collector side. That's why it is CC and LC indicated. And then C1 capacitor you have, and along with a piezoelectric crystal. So this is a basic configuration, because it's biasing condition, nothing is shown, just the feedback part, how crystal is used, it will be shown in this. Okay, further, a typical Miller oscillator using a junction FET is shown in figure F. So next figure we'll have that practical circuit including the FET. So see here, this is the circuit. So it is having VCC. Okay, so then you have varector, or it is called as gang condenser, parallel with inductor. So here you have the junction FET with its Q factor, and here you have the input resistance R1, and the crystal is connected over there, okay, in parallel with that. And in the source side, you have the R2 resistor, and there is a bypass capacitance. This is the normal configuration of the amplifier. So here you will be having the feedback, okay. So this is the crystal will act as here feedback. So this is varector, gain condenser, bypass capacitor are connected over here. And the output is taken at the drain side with coupling capacitor C2. Okay, so this is one Miller oscillator practical circuit. Okay, so it may not be asked in exam, but it was there in the book, right? You should not miss that. So that's why I've included that. Anyhow, so after this session, I will send you all the important questions as in module one. So it's like a assignment two for you. Okay, you have to answer those questions in Google Classroom. Okay, I will upload that once it is ready, and with within the limited time, you have to answer those questions. Okay, problems again, I will not give as assignment. Problems already it is there in your notes. So solve that. Okay, only little changes in the values they may make. There is no much thing in the problem part. Okay, so it shows that the input of this oscillator is a signal generated by a crystal, and the output is obtained from a tank circuit load. Okay, so if you see the circuit, the input is a oscillator by a crystal, right? And output is a tank circuit where it is having capacitor and inductor in parallel. The inductance L1 and capacitor C1 of the tank circuit are adjusted to the desired resonant frequency. They are there for adjustment. In general, the inductor is chosen to have a fixed value L1 and the capacitance C1 is varied. Okay, in general, this is the method they will use. That's why it is capacitor side. We have shown like this, right? So drawn the capacitor and then variant of this symbol we shown. So this is normally called as condenser. Okay, GaN condenser, some name they have mentioned it. Okay. So this is the idea of that circuit, okay, of the Miller oscillator. The output is taken at the drain end of the JFET itself or bypassed through a capacitor C2 as shown in the figure. The feedback in this circuit is provided by the drain source capacitance. Okay, so drain to source capacitance will give you the feedback. However, this itself is disadvantageous, okay, as different devices will have small variation in the values of CGD, gate to drain capacitance. This may lead to variation in the frequency. Okay, further, the output may be subject to amplitude variations due to load conditions. The drawback of this circuit I am mentioning. An improved version of the Miller oscillator uses the dual gate MOSFET and is normally used as a fundamental mode oscillator with no overtones possible. Okay, so we are not discussing that. Okay, so the discussion may not end. Okay, so this is a very vast subject. Okay, whatever subject you have, each subject is a very vast, in that within the limit our syllabus we have to restrict. Okay, so that's why the crystal oscillator part you have to focus. Finally, I will tell you the different type of crystals available, crystal oscillators, and where they are used. Okay, so with that we'll wind up the session. The most important characteristic of the crystal oscillator is its stability. Okay, so this you always remember, crystal, why we use for stability. It will be much stable with temperature variation as well as I told you, right? So same way we have different oscillators. It is possible to have a temperature compensated crystal oscillator. We can modify the crystal for each of these application stability purpose. So if temperature compensated crystal oscillator, in short we call crystal, normally indicated as X in English term, okay, not C. Okay, so that's why temperature compensated XO, crystal oscillator. Okay, so which finds use in many digital ICs. Okay, so in digital ICs this type of oscillators are used. Another type is the voltage controlled crystal oscillators, VCXO. Okay, so this is used in phase locked loop circuits, which is the application in communication circuit, phase locked loop. Okay, PLL we call in short. So this you will be studying in the next semester. Okay, when you are started with communication subject. Okay, so there you will come across this phase locked loop, where the frequency is controlled by the external voltage. So its frequency is controlled by the, that's why voltage controlled crystal oscillator we call. Okay, and finally we have another variety, O1 controlled crystal oscillator, OCXO. Okay, so it is also known to be most precise and highly stable oscillators. They are used in many wireless systems, your 4G, 5G, okay, and the Wi-Fi, whatever you say. So the wireless systems, so there it is used, and in particular at their base stations, cellular, okay, as I told you, 4G, 5G. So you will be having mobile phone, there is no connection, right? But there is a nearest tower which will catch the signal, right? So through that you will be communicating to your friends, family and all, okay, right? So that we call in our technical term, wireless system, we call base station. Again, this you will be studying at the 8th semester level about wireless communication, okay? Or 6th semester level, maybe you will be learning this, the cellular, okay? That is your subject, no? Electronics and communication. So all these are applications, and for that this crystal oscillator is the used, okay? So with this we are ending the crystal oscillators or the oscillator parts of the module 2. With that we are completing the module 2 of the analog circuits, okay? So go through, okay, important questions I will send, go through that, okay? Prepare the answers for that in brief, answering 6 marks or 8 marks question or 10 marks question, like that. Okay, don't explanation, you don't write much, simple explanation, in short you write, because I have given much things because to understand you, okay? So but you can shorten that while writing the, okay? So equations, diagrams give more important, okay? Don't miss any diagrams, any equations, okay? So that is important, but explanation wise anything is there, it is for your study, okay, understanding. So no need to complete much, but whenever they say some definition term, okay, then you have to write properly, okay? But explanation wise is there, you can condense it always, okay? So with that, we'll end the session here, and next session we'll come up with a new module.